everyone. Thank you for watching this special episode of Mr. Cowboys. We're here at the Farnsworth House and doing a two-part lockdown. First is here at the Farnsworth House, and another one we're going to Satchel's Bridge later on tonight. So if you like this episode, please subscribe and give us a big like or comment below to see what more you guys would like to see next. Alright, thank you and enjoy the episode.
What kind of stories have you heard for the guests that stayed here, like throughout their rooms and the inn?
Well, we had one guy that stayed here, and he stayed down in the Sarah Black room.
Mm-hmm.
And he was sleeping, and he woke up, and he heard two people screaming out in the hallway. He thought they were just drunk and had come in from the tavern. So he went and whipped a door open, and nobody was there. And he's like, all right, well, I guess they went to their rooms. Okay, so he went back to bed, closed the door, whatever, locked it, and then he woke up in the middle of the night to two what he thought were drunk reenactors at the end of his bed that had just happened to come into his room,
yeah.
And he was really mad because they were whispering back and forth, like, what should we do with him? Should we push him off the bed? What should we do? And so he turned and he pulled on the light and sat up, and he froze because he saw the reenactors, but he only saw them from the stomach up.
Have you ever had your own personal experience up here or throughout the house?
Here, just the door opening a lot. One time we had the smell of pipe tobacco. It was really thick. It started in the corner over there, and nobody could smell it but a couple people, and it just kind of swept through the entire attic. It got so thick, I, as a tour guide, was really scared because I thought something was on fire downstairs, but then it just kind of immediately went away, and as we went downstairs past, nothing smelled like smoke. So it only smelled like that for like a minute, and then it was gone. And then down in the cellar, I was talking, and everybody was on the left side of the cellar, and on the right side, I saw a girl with a black hood, I guess you could describe it as like a black hood, get up from the right back of the right side of the cellar and go forward really fast. And you know, that's a normal thing, because people get scared sometimes when they leave the cellar or they want to move seats, whatever. I didn't really think much of it until I got outside and I realized that every one of my guests had been sitting on the left side. And I knew that because I'd seen where all of them were. And she just kind of appeared and got up and moved and then never saw her sit back down.
Wow.
It was cool. I also saw Jeremy. I was talking and looking at the back of the cellar, and we were walking. I saw just like a little head all of a sudden just like come out from behind where there's a wall against the stairs. And he like hopped down two stairs and went past the pole and was gone. It was so cool. It was really cool. It was really hard to like keep my composure as I'm like trying to tell stories, but it was really cool.
What did Jeremy look like?
For me, he was a dark shadow. I could tell he had like a little bowl cut, and he had some suspenders on, but everything was like pretty much, his face was a dark shadow, and like black and white, but
Right,
where would you like to go?
We can go to the stair box, and we can turn off the lights and stuff like that.
Ooh, nothing big.
Night vision. Recording, Sarah Black's room, Lexi, Spencer, what's her name?
Caitlin,
and me?
I forgot her name.
All alone in the house.
And Jeremy.
Sitting down a recorder. Alright, if there's anybody here in the room with us, followed us from upstairs and came down here, can you please speak into this red light right here, tell us your name? Can you tell us why are you staying in this house? Can you tell us why are you staying in this house? Who is haunting this room? Why are you haunting this room?
Is it comfy in this room?
When we first came here, in a sumptuous room. Like, is there anybody here in this room with us? Can you tell us what's the name of this building? That's it, Farnsworth. Can you tell us what's the name of this room?
Are you a boy or a girl?
Boy. Boy.
I heard that.
Can you tell us how old you are?
7? 5?
No, it was radio.
I have 5.
Can you tell us how old you are?
Can you say one of our names?
Which one?
Mine? Can you try again?
Do you know this woman in the dress? What's her name? I think there's this pouncing. I have this device right here. Might be a little bit easier for you. This is called a millimeter of rim. If you come up towards it, it will slide up. Can you please come and do that? Touch this silver stick. It won't poke you or anything.
Like this. Ooh. Pretty colors.
Well, you guys want to finish it off in the basement?
Sure.
Oh, I lit up. Yeah.
Alright, let's go in the basement.
Where would you like to go?
We can do a stair box. And we can turn off the lights and stuff like that.
Nothing big.
You want night fishing? Recording, Sarah Black's room, Lexi, Spencer, what's her name?
Caitlin,
and me.
I forgot her name.
All alone in the house.
And Jeremy.
Sitting down a recorder. Alright, if there's anybody here in the room with us, followed us from upstairs and came down here, can you please speak into this red light right here, tell us your name? Can you tell us why are you staying in this house? Can you tell us why are you staying in this house? Who is haunting this room? Why are you haunting this room?
Is it comfy in this room?
When we first came here, in a sumptuous room. Like, is there anybody here in this room with us? Can you tell us what's the name of this building? That's it, Farnsworth. Can you tell us what's the name of this room?
Are you a boy or a girl?
Boy. Boy.
I heard that.
Can you tell us how old you are?
7? 5?
No, it was radio.
I have 5 years.
Can you tell us how old you are?
Can you say one of our names?
Which one?
Mine? Can you try again?
Do you know this woman in the dress? What's her name? I think there's this count scene. I have this device right here. Might be a little bit easier for you. This is called a millimeter of rim. If you come up towards it, it will slide up. Can you please come and do that? Touch this silver stick. It won't poke you or anything.
Like this. Ooh. Pretty colors.
Well, you guys want to finish it off in the basement?
Sure.
Oh, like, what about that? Yeah.
Alright, let's go in the basement. Does anybody here remember me? I know it's been a while. Is it true that people you bring Ouija boards to try to communicate with you?
Confederate Army of Northern Virginia began its retreat to Virginia by crossing the bridge after the Battle of Gettysburg in July of 1863.
Is this the bridge that you guys, Confederates, cross over to escape the battle? What are the three Confederate soldiers' names that was hung on the rafters? What was your crime?